Yan. So, good afternoon once again. So, for today, we are going to talk about introduction to one-dimensional kinematics. Okay, so one-dimensional kinematics, from the word one-dimensional, so we are going to talk about linear kinematics. So, we'll delve into this a little deeper as we go along our lesson for today. Okay? So, ito yung tanong ko kanina, but this one, itong susunod na tanong is actually graded, ano? So, true or false, kinematics is the study of motion which considers the forces that affect the motion. So, ang tanong dito, ang kinematics ba is the study of motion which considers the forces that affect the motion. So, is it true or false? You have 15 seconds to answer this one. So your time starts now. Yan, close ko muna no yung responses natin. Okay, may question dito sa group chat. Hello sir, good afternoon po. Sir, mahina po ang net dito yan, mi sir. Agrek-reconnect ay signal. Ask ko lang po kung DJ class point nung kati attendance kasi last meeting circuit madinak na ka-unanswered gaputi poor connection, sir. Hope for your consideration, sir. Thank you. Yes, the class point will be the attendance. You can join the class point kasi ano naman yan, hindi naman yan nakakaano ng bandwidth masyado. Sir, ano po yung code? Yung code natin makikita dito sa upper right. Makikita nyo naman, 87685. 87685. All right, so 62% answered A, while 38% answered B. Ano kaya ang correct answer dito? The correct answer is B. Bakit? Ano kaya ang problema natin dito? Ano ang mali dito sa statement natin? Yan. Kinematics is the study of motion which considers the forces that affect the motion. This is false. Bakit false? Kasi sa kinematics, we don't deal with forces. Ano? We do not deal with forces. So sa kinematics, hindi muna natin papakialaman yung forces. Nandiyan yan sa, ano ninyo, sa libro ninyo. Ano? So kinematics, we are going to talk about motion without actually considering the forces involved doon sa motion. Yun yung susunod natin actually na papag-usapan, ano, yung sa next chapter natin, yung dynamics. So when we talk about kinematics, kinematics is defined as the study of motion without considering its causes. So we don't deal with alam naman natin that the cause of motion is force, tama? So sa kinematics, we deal with motion without considering the causes. Okay? So the word kinematics comes from a Greek term meaning motion and is related to other English words such as cinema, movies, and kinesiology. So this is the origin of the word kinematics. Alright? So yun yung tanong, sagot sa tanong natin kanina na yung kinematics, hindi muna natin i-consider yung forces that causes the motion. Okay? So, more specifically, yung one-dimensional kinematics is the study of motion along a straight line. And dito sa one-dimensional kinematics, we consider the object as particles. No? So, particles la. So, parang ano-ano, we simplify the objects model, di ba yung discussion natin last meeting, we model the object as a single point. Yun yung ano natin dito sa kinematics. Ano, imo-model natin yung object as a single point lang. We don't really actually considering yung geometry ng isang object. No? Basta kung anumang object yan, consider lang natin as a point. Yun yung sa one-dimensional kinematics. At dito sa one-dimensional kinematics, ang i-consider lang natin is the motion along a straight line. Okay? So this one is the simplest type of motion. Okay? So for this chapter, we are going to focus on one-dimensional kinematics. So this is the outline of our discussion for today. We will talk about displacement and then vectors, scalars, and the coordinate systems. We're going to talk about time, velocity, and speed, and then acceleration, motion equations for constant acceleration in one dimension, and then problem-solving basics for one-dimensional kinematics. We'll talk about falling objects, and then we'll talk about graphical analysis of one-dimensional motion. So basically, this one is from our book. This is the outline of our book. Okay, so let's go to our first topic, which is on displacement. Okay, so please ready sa question natin. Meron tayong question dito. Yan, so the question is, kung nabasa nyo yung libro ninyo, masasagot nyo ito ng tama, no? So the distance traveled should always be equal or greater than the magnitude of the displacement. So we are comparing dalawang quantities dito, tama? The distance traveled and the magnitude of the displacement, dalawa. So the statement is, the distance traveled should always be equal or greater than the magnitude of the displacement. So is this true or false? Please answer. Yan. So yung tanong, makikita nyo naman dyan sa class point app ninyo. All right, so hati na naman ang class, ano? So 96 or 59% actually answered A, tapos 41% answered B. The correct answer is letter A. It's true. Bakit true? Okay? Bakit true, ano? So makikita natin mamaya, ano? So the distance traveled and the magnitude of the displacement. These are two different terms, ano? So we'll talk about these terms later on. So tingnan natin yung leaderboard muna. Oh, yan. 0058. Kung nakikita niyo yung student number niyo diyan, congratulations, ano? Nasa top kayo. All right? So yan, we have here another question. Okay? Which of the following is true? Yan, so distance, ito naman pinag-uusapan natin distance, ano? So distance can have a positive or negative value. Distance can only have positive values. Distance can only have negative values. Or letter D, distance should always be positive and a direction should be specified. So ano kaya yung distance? If you know the meaning of distance, if you have read yung libro ninyo, you can answer this one easily. Okay? So you have 15 seconds to answer the question. Yeah. So gawin na nating 30 para makasagot lahat. 30 seconds. 10 seconds. Sige, bilisan nyo. Pasagutin na lang natin lahat. One minute na lang. Yan. So, meron tayong haan nga recorded no kwa kapag haan nga ma-click jay submit. You have to submit your answer in class point. You know? Click nyo yung choice nyo and then click submit. Hindi siya mare-record kapag hindi nyo click yung submit. Okay, dito meron tayong, oy, walang sumagot ng C. But parang hati na naman yung klase, ano? A, B, or D. Okay? So, ang sagot natin dito, the correct answer is letter B. Yan. So, distance can only have positive values. Because distance, as we know, kung nabasa nyo yung libro nyo, distance is a scalar quantity, you know? So it does not make sense kung may negative value, kung may negative sign yung distance. Kapag may negative na, ibig sabihin, vector quantity na yon, and we talk about displacement na, no? Kapag ganon, alright? So distance is the scalar counterpart of displacement. So dito, dapat si distance palaging merong positive value lamang. Okay? So B is the correct answer. And I think meron pa tayong wala na. Okay. So before we study yung displacement, pag-aralan muna natin kung ano yung position. Okay? So position is where an object is at any particular time relative to a convenient reference frame. Position. So nasaan ka? Nasaan yung lugar mo? But before you can answer that one, ang tanong, nasaan in reference to what? In reference to what? So for example, dito sa figure natin, itong teacher na to, ang kanyang position dito ay x sub 0, meron siyang 1.5 meters, tama? Saan galing itong 1.5 meters? This one, 1.5 meters from the origin ito. So basically, itong point na to, this point is our reference frame. Yan, ito. Ito yung ating reference frame, ano? So itong 1.5 meters is measured from our reference frame. Nandyan yan. So this is the position of the teacher at this point. And naglakad yung teacher papunta dito sa right part. So ang kanyang position at this point now is at 3.5 meters from our reference frame. Okay, so yung position is always stated with respect to a reference frame. So dito meron tayong ginawang x and y axis ano as our reference frame. Pero sa one-dimensional motion, we only talk about a single axis. So in this case, itong x-axis lang yung actually kailangan natin. Ano? So yan yung position ng teacher at this point with respect to our reference frame na nandito. Okay? So yan. So we can only define position with respect to a reference frame. Meron akong tanong ano dati. For example, nasa bus ka. Nasa bus or nasa jeep or nasa sasakyan. Tapos yung sasakyan mo is moving. So ang tanong, are you moving or not? Ikaw na nasa loob ng sasakyan, are you moving or not? So ang sagot doon is actually it depends, ano? It depends. Kung for example, ang reference point mo is nasa labas ng sasakyan, for example, a tree outside the vehicle, then you are moving with respect to that reference frame. Pero kung ang reference frame mo ay yung upuan mo doon sa loob ng sasakyan, then you are not moving with respect to that reference frame. Okay, so yung position natin, generally motion should be with respect to a certain reference frame. Alright? Yan, pwede na nating i-define ang displacement. Displacement with the symbol of delta x. So this one is a Greek letter, capital letter delta. So this is delta x is the change in position of an object. So sa physics or any other sciences, kapag nakakita kayo ng symbol na ganito na delta, ito represents change, ano? Itong delta represents change. So kung meron kayong nakitang delta x, alam natin x is the symbol for position. So delta x is the change in position. At ang change in position is what we call the displacement. So ang formula for displacement is delta x is equal to the final position minus the initial position. So ang ating final position, meron tayong subscript na f. Yung ating initial position ay merong subscript na 0. So basically, Ang sinasabi, the displacement is just the difference between your final position and your initial position. So, isubtract tayo lang, i-minus tayo lang, di ba? Yan. Delta x is the displacement. X sub f is the final position. And x sub 0 is the initial position. So, displacement has both magnitude and direction. Yan. So, ang displacement daw, merong magnitude at mayroong direction. So direction can be specified with a plus or minus sign. So in this case, kung titingnan natin itong teacher kanina na example natin, ang kanyang initial position ay 1.5 meters. This is our x sub 0, di ba? Ang kanyang final position ay x sub f na 3.5 meters. So ang kanyang displacement delta x is equal to the final position minus the initial position. Eh, that's 3.5 minus 1.5. And we come up with positive. So meron tayong positive sign dito or plus sign na ganito, plus 2.0 meters. Ano ang ibig sabihin ng plus sign nito? Ang ibig sabihin ng plus sign nito, the direction of the displacement is towards the positive direction. So basically, bago nating i-compute yung displacement, kailangan muna nating i-identify kung nasa ang direction ang positive. Pero as in our class, dito sa klase natin, we always specify yung to the right na direction, yung positive. So ibig sabihin yung to the left na direction ay negative. So in this case, itong example natin dito na teacher na nasa board, nag-move siya to the right. So ibig sabihin ang kanyang displacement ay positive kasi nag-move siya to the right. Tama? So ang magnitude, 'di ba sabi ko displacement has both magnitude and direction. So ang magnitude ng displacement niya ay ito mismo, itong 2.0. Ito na yung magnitude niya, 2.0 meters. Yan na yung magnitude. Itong positive ngayon nito, this specifies the direction. This now is the direction. So ibig sabihin ng positive na yan, the displacement is to the right. Alright? So yun yung displacement. So in specifying displacement, meron siyang dapat magnitude and direction. Okay. So another example dito is we have a negative displacement. So yung passenger, itong matabang to, nandito, yung upuan niya, no? Ang kanyang initial position from our reference frame dito ay 6 meters, 6.0 meters. And then, naglakad siya pabalik, ano? Naglakad siya to the left. At ang kanyang final position now, x sub f, is 2.0 meters. So kung titingnan ninyo, his final position is 2.0 and his initial position is 6.0. And his displacement is to the left, tama? To the left. So using our formula, x sub f minus x sub 0, that's 2.0 minus 6.0. So magkakaroon tayo ng negative 4.0. This is a negative displacement. Ang ibig sabihin ng negative na displacement, the motion is towards the left or towards the negative direction. Okay? So that's the negative displacement. A negative displacement means that the motion is towards the negative direction in our coordinate system. So, ayun yung dalawang example natin. Positive displacement means to the right, negative displacement means to the left yung motion. Okay? Ito naman distance, ano? Distance is defined to be the magnitude or size of displacement between two positions. Okay, so ang distance ay yung magnitude mismo ng displacement. Okay? So in this case, yung distance hindi pwedeng ano, walang positive or negative yung distance. Ito na yung question natin kanina, no? This is just the magnitude or size. So it does not matter kung yung displacement mo is negative or positive. Distance is just the magnitude. So in this case, yung ating unang example, ang distance traveled niya or ang distance niya ay 2.0. Alright? Dito sa pangalawa, although to the left yung motion, yung displacement, ang distance travel niya is still 4.0. Ha? Walang negative kasi we are talking about distance. Ito, magkaiba din, ano? Magkaiba yung distance sa distance traveled. Distance traveled is the total length of the path traveled between two points. Ano? So distance has no direction and therefore has no sign. For example, anong pinagkaiba ng distance at distance traveled? For example, ano, nandito yung initial position natin. This is our initial position. And this is our final position. Yan. So yung path mo, hindi siya diretso. Ano? So nagnakapay lang na pandita, nagkilo ka pa kasta, and then kasjay, and then kasjay, and then ganyan. So itong path na trinabel mo, this is your total distance traveled. Yan, that is your distance traveled. Alright, pero kapag we talk about the distance, this is the magnitude of the displacement. Alam natin that the displacement is ito, from the initial position, to, diretso lang, sa, parang mag-draw lang tayo ng straight line papunta doon sa final position. Yan. So that is our displacement. So whatever the magnitude between the initial position and the final position, that is our distance. Ano? That is our distance. So naisip nyo na siguro ngayon ano, that distance traveled should always be greater than or equal to the distance or the magnitude of the displacement. Di ba? Hindi pwedeng mas maliit yung total distance traveled. Ano? Okay, so that's the difference between distance, the distance traveled, and the displacement. Ngayon, meron tayong example problem dito. Ano? So a cyclist rides 3 kilometers west and then turns around and rides 2 kilometers east. What is her displacement? What distance does she ride? And what is the magnitude of her displacement? Okay? So una, bago tayo makasagot nito, kailangan nating maglagay ng ating reference frame. Okay? So nandito yung zero natin. Remember ano, when we talk about the ano direction, ano yung ating ano four, ano ang tawag dito, four directions, di ba ang acronym niya ay news? Yan, news, north, east, west, south. So ang ano natin dito, to the right is east, to the left ay west, ba? So in this case, yung ating motion dito, nagsimula siya from a certain reference point. So nandito yung initial position niya. Okay? Sulat lang tayo. Hindi ako makadraw ng straight line dito. Assuming ano, na straight line na lang ito. Yan. So this is the initial position, zero. This one is our reference frame. Yan. So, i-model natin, ano, this is our initial position. So, nandito yung cyclist, yung point natin. And then, nag-ride siya 3 kilometers west. So, ibig sabihin, if this is measured in kilometers, this is 1, 2, 3. Nandito yung position 2 natin, ano? This is our position 2. Lagyan natin ng ano, ng P2 na lang, P2, position 2. Okay? So this is our P1 or P sub 0, ano? Kahit ano naman actually yung notation natin, okay lang as long as you understand the problem. Tapos it turns around and rides 2 kilometers east. So from this point, pupunta siya ulit dito. 2 kilometers, so pabalik siya ng 2 kilometers dito. Nandito na ngayon yung ating final position. So kung ano natin, kung lalagyan natin ng notation natin, ito yung x sub 0 natin, ito yung x sub f natin. Yan yung initial position tsaka final position. So ang tanong dito, wait lang. Una, for letter A, what is her displacement? So ano ang displacement? Dito, it does not matter ano kung ano, basta ang displacement is x sub f minus x sub o. Kailangan lang i-identify natin kung ano, kung nasaan yung final position, nasaan yung initial position. Okay, I'm sorry, dapat negative pala ito ano, kasi to the west. Parang yung number line lang natin, to the west. So negative. So kung to the east, positive yung ano natin, right? So nasa negative 3, pumunta siya sa negative 3 and then bumalik siya, pumunta sa negative 1. So in this case, ang ating final position ay negative 1, ang ating initial position ay 0. So ang ating displacement dito, delta x, is equal to negative 1. And then our unit, since dapat na kilometers ito, we are talking about kilometers. So negative 1 kilometer ang kanyang displacement. So ang ibig sabihin, ang kanyang final position relative to the initial position ay 1 kilometer to the left. Yan yung ibig sabihin ng displacement. Yan. So number 2, what is the distance that she ride? This is actually the total distance traveled, ano? This is the distance traveled. So, ano yung total distance travel niya? D na lang yung notation natin for distance. The distance is equal to, una, nag-move siya, no? From 0 papunta kay negative 3. Kung bibilangin natin, that's 3 kilometers. Ano? So, we have 3 kilometers. Tapos, bumalik siya ng another 2 kilometers. So, that's plus 2 kilometers. Okay, so, the distance traveled is 5 kilometers. Yan. So when we talk about distance, we don't mind kung positive or negative. Titingnan lang natin yung total na distance na travel. Actually, it's the magnitude ng displacement yan or magnitude yung travel niya. Dapat i-add natin lahat-lahat ng travel niya. We just, hindi lang yung final position at saka yung initial position nung tinitingnan natin at this point. Ano? Kailangan natin tingnan yung ruta, yung path ng motion. Okay? So, the third one, what is the magnitude of the displacement? Dito, ang titingnan lang natin is actually the displacement. Tingnan lang natin yung displacement. And the magnitude is ito. Whatever that is now the magnitude of the displacement. So parang ang magnitude of displacement is the absolute value of the displacement. Yan. So it's always positive. Kapag sinasabi nating magnitude of the displacement, it's the absolute value of the displacement. Okay? So yun na yung mga sagot natin sa tanong na ito, right? This one is actually problems from the book. Yan. So meron tayong iba't ibang path dito. We have point A, point B, point C and point D. For the first one, path A muna, yung A muna. So the distance traveled, this is diretsahan, ano? Point A starts from position 0. Di ba? Nagsimula siya sa position 0. Nagtapos siya doon sa between 6 and 8. Di ba? So, this is 7. Di ba? For path A, so, the distance traveled, since diretso lang yan, so the distance traveled is equal to 7. 7 meters, diretso lang, from 0 to 7. So, kapag ganyan na diretso lang yung motion, pare-parehas na yung kanyang distance at saka displacement. Kasi to the right din yan. Ano? For letter B, the magnitude of the displacement, so delta x magnitude, so absolute value of delta x from start to finish, that's 7 minus 0 then, you know? So 7 minus 0 is 7 meters. And the displacement, delta x, pare-parehas na ito, no? So xf minus xo, 7 meters then. Yan. So pare-parehas yung ganyang distance, the magnitude of the displacement, and the displacement. Kasi to the right naman yung motion, no? Okay, let's go for path B. For path B, as you can see, nagsimula siya dito sa 12. Nag-end siya dito sa, ano kaya to? 7 din? Or 8? Let's assume na 7 din, ano? Assume na 7. Assumption lang naman yan, okay? So, yung ating x initial position is 12 meters. Meters kasi yan yung unit dyan, ano? And our final position is 7 meters. So, ang motion is to the left. So, therefore, the distance traveled, we don't mind yung, ano, we don't mind the direction sa distance, di ba? So, nag-move lang siya ng 12 minus 7 or 7 minus 12, but we don't mind the sign. That's 5 meters. Okay? So, 5 meters. The magnitude of the displacement is the same as the distance kasi straight line lang naman yan. Hindi siya lumiko-liko. So, this is also 5 meters. But for the displacement mismo, the displacement is final position minus initial position. So that's 7 meters minus 12 meters. So we have negative 5 meters. So the displacement in this case is to the left. Diba? Nakikita naman sa figure that this is indeed to the left yung motion niya. Alright. So for letter C, ang kanyang initial position ay nasa 2. Ang kanyang final position nasa 11. Okay, baliktarin natin yung ano natin, yung solution natin. Unahin natin yung displacement. Delta x is x sub f minus x sub 0. So alam natin ang kanyang initial position ay nasa 2 meters. Ang kanyang final position ay nasa 11 meters. So therefore, ano lang ito, ano? 11 meters minus 2 meters. So, ang kanyang displacement is to the right na 9 meters. This is positive, right? This is positive 9 meters kasi to the right. And then, substituting dun sa formula, we can easily say that this is to the right. So, the magnitude of the displacement, absolute value of delta x, is just the magnitude. Hindi natin isasama yung positive or negative. So that is our displacement. This is the magnitude of the displacement. And the total distance traveled, check natin yan. The total distance traveled, we actually have to follow yung path. Ano? So from 2 papunta kay 10. Ano yan? So 10 minus 2, nag-travel siya ng 8 meters. Di ba? From dito, pumunta rito. And then bumalik siya, pumunta sa 8. That's 2 meters. Tapos, from here, bumalik ulit siya papunta kay 11. So we have 3 meters. Okay? So pinag-add natin yung kanyang path. Okay? So the distance traveled, therefore, is 13 meters. Okay? And then, finally, for path D, yan. So, ang kanyang initial position, x sub 0 is nasa 9 meters. Ang kanyang final position nandito, assume natin na nasa 5. Ano? So, the final position is 5 meters. So, we can directly compute for the displacement, delta x sub f minus x sub 0. So, this is 5 meters minus 9 meters. Therefore, delta x is negative 4 meters. So alam natin that the final position is to the left of the initial position because of this negative sign. So the magnitude of the displacement, absolute value of delta x, is just 4 meters. Okay, and the distance is, we need to add the total path traveled. So from 9, pumunta sa 5, that's 4. Ano pala ito? 3 pala ito, ano? Hindi kaya. 3. 9 tapos 3. 9 minus 3, that's 6, di ba? 6, tapos bumalik siya sa 5. So that's 6 plus 2. That's 6 meters plus 2 meters. So the total distance traveled is 8 meters. Yan. So we have the displacement, the magnitude of the displacement, and the distance traveled for path D. Alright? Any question? Do you have any question? Alright. Okay, so here is a problem that you will answer on class point. An ant starts at x equals 20 centimeters on a piece of graph paper and walks along the x-axis to x equals negative 20 centimeters. It then turns around and walks back to x equals negative 10 centimeters. Determine the ant's displacement and the total distance traveled. Okay, so answer this one for, siguro for 2 minutes. Kung hindi kaya ng 2 minutes, please let me know para ma-extend natin. Okay? Yan. So meron ng sumagot na dalawa. So what is the displacement of the ant? And what is the total distance traveled? Five seconds. Someone is raising his hand. Mr. Agres, yes?
Sir, ask lang DJ, ano tatay, DJ, question tatay, previous slide. Is it safe to assume nga, DJ in between, is it safe to assume nga 9 or something like, is it assume a number lata nga, for example, J8 can 10 tatay, sir. Is it safe to assume nga 9 DJ latan, sir?
As our, ano, for discussion purposes, we'll assume na, ano yan, na nasa 9. Ano? Pero if you have more, ano, more, siguro more precise measurement, you can actually interpolate kung ano talaga yung distance niyan. But as you can see, ano, it's safe, ano, na to assume na 9 yan. Okay? Para sa discussion lang natin, sa discussion, mas madali lang isolve kapag naka-integer, di ba? Ay, naka, oo, naka-whole number, right?
Yes, sir.
Yan. Tignan natin yung sagot ninyo dito. Mostly answered letter D, ano? 71%. The correct answer is letter D. Okay, bakit letter D? The displacement is negative 30. Kung titignan ninyo, the object starts at x equals 20 meters. Okay? So, nandito siya sa 20 meters. Dito siya nag-start. Tapos, nag-travel siya papunta kay negative 20. So, negative 20, centimeters pala ito, sorry. Centimeters. Okay? So, nandito yung second na point niya. So, as you can see, dito pa lang, the distance traveled is already 20 plus 20. So, that's 40 meters. Tapos, bumalik siya, negative 10. So, nandito yung negative 10. So, pumunta siya doon and then bumalik, di ba? Dito, pumunta siya doon and then bumalik. Ito na yung kanyang final position. Okay? Nakita nyo yung path, ano? From 20 to negative 20, pabalik dito kay negative 10. So, the total distance traveled is 20 plus 20 plus 10. So, that's 50 meters. So, kung titignan ninyo, ito lang yung tatlong choices. Ano? Wala na yung B for the total distance traveled. So, the displacement naman is just the difference between the final position and the initial position. So, the final position is negative 10. The initial position is 20. So, delta x is equal to the final, which is negative 10, minus the initial, which is 20. So, negative minus that one. So, we have negative 30 centimeters. So, ito ngayon yung delta x niya. Ano? So, therefore, ang sagot natin dito ay letter D. Yan. So, yan. I am happy. 71%. At least yung 29% merong, or this is 30%, hindi siya equal to 100%. Meron kayong room for improvement. Tingnan natin kung sino nasa leaderboard. Yan, so itong 050058 is our top muna dito sa class point natin. Okay, let's go to our next topic. We have vectors, scalars, and coordinate system. Kung napansin ninyo, kanina sinasabi ko, distance is a scalar quantity, displacement is a vector quantity, ganyan. Okay, so ano ba yung vector, ano yung scalar? But I think meron tayong tanong dito. Yan, meron tanong dito for a class point ulit. Which of the following is not a vector quantity? Kung alam nyo yung meaning ng vector, masasagot nyo ito. Ano? Letter A, 50 meter per second to the right. Letter B, negative 20 meters. Letter C, 3 kilonewtons. Or letter D, 90 kilometer per hour due north. Okay, so which of the following is not a vector quantity? Okay, you have 15 seconds and your time starts now. Parang naghahang yung timer ng class point. Yan. So, time is up. Ay. Medyo naman. Some answered B. Half. Almost half of the class answered B. While C, 3 kilonewtons. Ang tamang sagot dito ay letter C, 3 kilonewtons. So, although it's a force, alam natin, yung kanyang unit ay kilonewton, force yan. Pero in this case, hindi naka-specify yung direction. Walang direction ito. Ano? So, ibig sabihin, this one is not a vector quantity. Okay? So, itong letter B kasi, although this is in meters, meron siyang negative sign indicating the direction. Diba na pag-usapan natin kanina sa displacement, kapag may negative sign yan, yung negative sign na yan indicates direction. Yan. So, the answer here is letter C. Yan. Is wind blowing at 20 knots a scalar quantity or a vector quantity? Wind blowing at yung 20 knots, yung knots parang ano yan, di ba? Na nagamit natin yan sa pre-calculus natin. Knots is nautical miles per hour. So that's actually a unit for speed, di ba? Nautical miles per hour. So is it a scalar or a vector quantity? 15 seconds. Bakit parang walang sumasagot? Ay, meron na. Bigla na lang dumami. Okay, time is up. Yes, of course, it's a scalar quantity. We will talk more about this one later on. No? Sana ma-realize ninyo later on kung bakit ito is scalar. And bakit itong letter C is not a vector quantity? Yan. So what is a vector? A vector is any quantity with both magnitude and direction. So meron siyang magnitude, meron siyang direction. A vector is can be represented by an arrow, kagaya ng nasa picture natin. Oh, so basically, a vector is an arrow. Ito, meron siyang tail at meron siyang head. Itong haba, no, kung gaano kahaba yung arrow natin, this signifies the magnitude of the vector. Okay? At itong kung saan siya naka-point yung arrow, yun yung kanyang direction. So, a vector has both magnitude and direction. Examples of vector is a velocity of 90 kilometers per hour. Ito yung kanyang magnitude, 90 kilometers per hour, is. Itong is the direction. Okay? Or a force of 500 newtons is straight down. So meron tayong 500 newtons na magnitude at meron tayong direction na straight down, pababa. Okay? So, when we define vector, dapat may magnitude at merong direction. Kapag drawing natin yung vector, dapat arrow na yung kanyang magnitude or yung haba ng arrow nakadepende sa magnitude ng vector at saka yung kanyang direction nakadepende sa direction ng vector natin. Okay? Whereas a scalar quantity has a magnitude but no direction. Scalar. Meron siyang magnitude, walang direction. Examples, 20 degrees Celsius temperature. Meron siyang 20 degrees Celsius temperature, wala siyang direction. 250 calories of energy in a candy bar. A 90 kilometer per hour speed limit. A person's height of 1.8 meters. A distance of 2.0 meters. These are all scalar. Walang direction itong mga to, ano? So, sa inyo, dapat vector kayo, ano? Dapat meron kayong direction sa buhay. Hindi pwedeng scalar. Walang direction. Yun ang example natin dyan. Yan. So, coordinate systems for one-dimensional motion. So, ito na yung sinasabi ko kanina, ano? Na sa atin, When describing horizontal motion, motion to the right is usually considered positive and motion to the left is considered negative. So yun yung ating parang anong tawag doon natin, parang agreement natin dito sa klase, ano? Kapag nagsosolve tayo, lahat ng motion natin na to the right are positive, lahat ng motion natin to the left ay negative. The same is true when we talk about vertical motion. Lahat ng pataas na motion ay positive, lahat ng pababa na motion ay negative. Pero one-dimensional muna tayo. We only consider the horizontal axis or the vertical axis one at a time. Ano? Yan. So now we talk about time, velocity, and speed. Ay, meron ulit tayong class point dito. Checkpoint lang para sa mga nagbasa, no? The average velocity of an object is equal to the total distance traveled divided by the time of travel. So, ang average velocity ba equal siya sa total distance traveled divided by the time of travel? True or false? You have 15 seconds. The average velocity of an object, is it equal to the total distance traveled divided by the time of travel? True or false? Oh, atin na naman ang klase, ano? True or false? The correct answer is false. Bakit false? Malalaman natin mamaya. Kasi ang ginamit natin dito is the total distance traveled. It should not be the total distance traveled. It should be the displacement. Velocity is equal to displacement divided by time. Hindi distance divided by time. Malalaman natin mamaya kung ano ang differences ng velocity sa speed sa at ano ang gagamitin natin. Kapag velocity, ano ang gagamitin natin na formula? Kapag speed, ano ang gagamitin natin na formula? Tingnan muna natin yung responses leaderboard natin. Hindi pa rin nagbabago yung top natin, ano? 0058. Yan, unahin muna natin yung time. So time is the interval over which a change in some physical quantity occurs. Dapat in ita na. Time is the interval over which a change in some physical quantity occurs. Okay, so yan yung definition ng time. Yung kung may parang mayroong changes sa isang physical quantity, anong interval niya, yun yung time. Okay? We cannot really measure time kung walang changes sa isang physical quantity, some physical quantity. Okay? So, sa atin, ang mine-measure natin yung time usually by the hands of the clock. Kung nag-imbakar DJ second hand, may sangaraya, that's 1 second. Diba? Nag-value DJ langa DJ orasan, so nag-value the physical, some physical quantity nag-value, and that's how we measure time. Over some changes in some physical quantity. Okay? So in kinematics, elapsed time, delta T, di ba? Nakakita naman tayo ng delta dito, meaning this is change in time. Okay? Elapsed time or delta T is the difference between the ending time and the beginning time. So final time minus initial time, delta T. Usually, sa ating study ng kinematics, the motion starts at time equals zero. So palaging ganun, ano, yung ano natin. So para ma-simplify yung ating analysis, sineset natin at the start of motion, that is when the time is equal to zero. So ang ano natin, itong t sub zero is equal to zero. So ibig sabihin, itong delta t ngayon is actually equal to the time t. Ito na yung symbol natin. The symbol t is used for elapsed time unless otherwise specified. So yung delta T, pwede natin gamitin T. Wala nang delta, no? Yun na yung sa ating formula later on. Hindi na natin gagamitin yung delta t, but instead t na lang. This is on the assumption na yung ating initial time is zero. Okay? So that is time. So yung velocity, eto na, no? The average velocity is equal to the displacement or the change in position divided by the time of travel. Diba? So ang ating symbol for average velocity is v dito, tapos merong bar sa taas. Usually kapag nakakakita tayo ng bar, may bar sa taas na letra, usually ang ano natin yan is average, di ba? Kagaya ng symbol natin for the mean, di ba? X bar. So itong v bar, that's for average velocity. So ang formula natin for average velocity, this involves the displacement divided by the time. Okay? Delta x over delta t. So kapag ano natin, xf minus xo all over tf minus to. Diba? Change in position over change in time. Pero sabi natin kanina, since yung initial time natin ay sineset natin to zero, so ang ating formula can be written as the average velocity is equal to delta x over time. Diba? So this is our formula for average velocity. It's just the change in position all over time. Meron din tayong tinatawag na instantaneous velocity. You know? Instantaneous velocity is the average velocity at the specific instant in time. Okay, over an infinitesimally small time interval. So itong term na infinitesimally small, usually ginagamit ito sa ano, sa calculus ninyo, di ba? Para maintindihan natin yung instantaneous velocity. For example, nandito ka sa initial position, position A, punta ka sa position B. Nag-travel ka, no? Travel. So usually, kapag ginamit natin yung position A tsaka position B, that is the average velocity. Kapag ginamitan natin ng xf minus xo all over the elapsed time, delta t. Yan. For some interval, kung malayo yan, yung average velocity is, ano lang, is just the average. Kapag sinummarize natin, that is your average velocity from point A to point B. Pero kung gusto natin, for example, at this point, ano yung velocity at this point? Kung we are talking about a specific instant, yan, a specific instant, we are talking about instantaneous velocity. So ano ang velocity niya dito? Anong pinaliit natin? Pinaliit natin yung time. So ito lang yung time interval na kinoconsider natin at this point. Kaya tinawag na infinitesimally small time interval. So paliit ng paliit yung time. Okay? In this case, ito yung gagamitin natin na initial position and the final position. So you will learn more about the instantaneous velocity sa inyong calculus class. Di ba meron kayong calculus ngayon? Maano ninyo yung definition pa ng instantaneous velocity sa calculus class ninyo. But for now, yung definition natin for instantaneous velocity. This is the average velocity at a specific instant over a very small amount of time. Okay? Iba siya sa average speed, ano? Yung average velocity, we talk about the change in position over time. Dito sa average speed, we talk about the total distance traveled. Okay, this is the total distance traveled divided by the elapsed time. Magkaiba. Doon sa velocity, displacement over time. Dito sa speed, distance over time. So anong pinagkaiba nun? Displacement is a vector quantity. Distance is a scalar quantity. Later on, mapag-aralan natin bakit. Yan, alam naman natin na na yung distance is the total distance traveled is we just add all the distances to come up with the total distance traveled. Doon sa displacement, we just subtract the initial from the we subtract the initial from the final position. Tama. Let us take a look at this one. A commuter train travels from Baltimore to Washington, D.C. and back in 1 hour and 45 minutes. The distance between the two stations is approximately 40 miles. What is the average velocity of the train and the average speed of the train in meters per second? So, gagawin pa tayo ng ng conversion. So we are going to write our answer in meters per second. Para mas madali, i-convert na natin lahat yung mga given natin. Given into meters and second. So yung 1 hour and 45 minutes is the time, tama? Pumunta from Baltimore to Washington DC and back. So the sa elapsed time, the time, this is our time, 1 hour and 45 1 hour and 45 minutes. So paano natin ito i-convert into seconds? Kailangan natin ito i-convert into seconds. So kailangan natin i-convert yung 1 hour into seconds. Alam natin 1 hour is 3600 seconds. Di ba? So 1 hour is 3600 seconds. Cancel na ngayon yung hour. So ito ngayon yung 1 hour. Tapos i-add natin yung 45 minutes. So 45 minutes times, alam natin that 1 minute is 60 seconds, di ba? So we now have the time, okay? Wala akong calculator, wait lang. Okay, so we have 3600. That's 1 times 3600 plus 45 times 60. So we have, kasi cancel na yung minute tsaka minute dyan, 6,300 seconds. So that's the time. And then the distance. Okay, the distance between the two stations is approximately 40 miles. I-convert natin yung 40 miles. 40 miles times, ano na ulit yung ano natin, conversion factor natin from miles to ano, to kilometer muna. 1 mile is 1.609 kilometers, tama? Tapos i-convert natin yung kilometer to meter. 1 kilometer is 1,000 meters. So itong 40 miles ngayon is now equal to 40 times 1.609 times 1,000. Okay, cancel yung miles, mile, kilometer to kilometer. Meron tayong 64,360 meters. So yan yung distance between Baltimore and Washington, D.C. All right, for letter A, ang unknown natin ay average velocity. So V bar. Okay. V bar is equal to, the average velocity is equal to delta X over time. Di ba? Okay, let us imagine kung anong nangyari dito sa problem natin. Yung train, pumunta siya from Baltimore to Washington, D.C. And then from Washington, D.C., bumalik siya sa Baltimore. So, ito yung ating, ano, ito ay yung Baltimore natin. Nandito yung Washington, D.C. So, this is our initial position. This is our final position. So, pumunta siya dyan, pero bumalik din. Tama? So, ano kaya dito itong delta x? What is our delta x in this case? Eh, ang initial position is equal to the final position kasi bumalik siya. doon sa Baltimore, bumalik siya. In this case, our initial position is equal to the final position. So the average velocity therefore is zero over whatever the time. Ano? Zero na to. So our average velocity is equal to zero. Diba? Kasi bumalik yung ating object doon sa kanyang initial position. Okay, for letter B, the average speed, so S, is equal to the total distance traveled all over the time. Okay? The speed is equal to the distance traveled all over the time. Dito, ang total distance na travel niya ay hindi zero. Kasi the total distance traveled is actually the path of the object. Tama? So from Baltimore going to Washington, D.C., and then plus Washington, D.C. to Baltimore. So this is twice this one. 64,360. Dalawang 64,360 meters. Okay? Yun yung difference ngayon ng displacement tsaka distance traveled. All over the time. The time is 6,300 seconds. So this is our average speed. Our average speed is twice 64,360 divided by 6,300. So this is 20.4317 meters per second. Okay, that is now the average speed. I hope ano na nakita ninyo ano yung difference ng average velocity tsaka speed. When we talk about velocity, we only talk about the initial position and the final position. It does not matter kung saan siya pumunta no sa velocity. Ang tinitingnan lang natin yung initial and final positions. Whereas sa speed, kailangan natin i-follow yung path. I-add natin lahat ng kanyang distance na na-travel for the distance over time. Any question? Meron kayong tanong dito? Okay. So I hope you got the difference of velocity and speed. Let's try another problem. The speed of propagation of the action potential, electrical signal, in a nerve cell depends on the diameter of the axon. If the nerve cell connecting the spinal cord to your feet is 1.1 meters long and the nerve impulse speed is 18 meters per second, how long does it take for the nerve signal to travel the distance? So in this case, ano yung mga given natin? Ano yung mga given natin? Una, meron akong nakita dito 1.1 meters tsaka 18 meters per second. Itong 1.1 meters is actually the distance, di ba? That's our distance. The distance is 1.1 meters. Distance ang ano natin, symbol natin, if we don't mind the ano, if we don't mind the direction. Okay? Distance lang. So it does not matter kung ano yan, pababa or pataas or whatever. Basta the distance between the two points is 1.1 meters. And then, meron tayong speed dito. Ano? The speed is 18 meters per second. And our unknown, is how long? Okay, how long does it take for the nerve signal to travel? So when we talk about yan, how long, we talk about time, di ba? So our unknown is time. So we know that the relationship solution between distance, speed, and time is, di ba, distance is equal to, or speed is equal to distance over time. So when we solve for t in terms of the other variables, the time is equal to distance over speed. Ito ngayon yung formula natin in solving for the time. Okay? So the distance is 1.1 meters divided by the speed of 18 meters per second. So the time is equal to That's 1.1 divided by 18. Okay? Kung titignan ninyo dito, cancel yung meters, meters, punta sa taas yung second. So, ang sagot natin dito ay second. So, this 0.0611. This is ano. Pero kapag ganito ng mga ano, mga sagot, I suggest na gumamit kayo ng ano ng scientific notation. So dahil the scientific notation of this one is 6.1111 times 10 raised to negative 2 seconds. Okay? Yan yung sagot natin. Para ano, para 4 significant digits palagi tayo dito sa decimal place niya. Okay? Paano ba i-input ito sa MBLE ulit? 6.1111 exponent negative 2. Yan. Yung pagkasulat sa MBLE. Diretso lang yan. So that is our answer for this problem. Another one, ano? On May 26, 1934, a streamlined stainless steel diesel train called the Zephyrs set the world's non-stop long-distance speed record for trains. It runs from Denver to Chicago, took 13 hours, 4 minutes, 58 seconds, and was witnessed by more than a million people along the route. The total distance traveled was 1,633.8 kilometers. What was its average speed in kilometers per hour? So, dalawa lang naman yung given natin, ano? The time and the distance. Ang tinatanong is the speed in kilometers per hour and meters per second. Okay. For letter A, alam natin the formula is distance over time. So the distance is 1,633.8 kilometers. Dito lang nagkakaiba sa ano sa time kasi given tayo ng hour, minutes, tapos seconds. Ang kailangan natin hour, ano? So convert muna tayo. Convert muna tayo. I-convert natin yung time. So the time is equal to, i-convert muna natin into hour kasi yun yung unang ano, di ba? Hour. So yung 13 hours, ganun na yan. Hindi natin papalitan. Itong 4 minutes, i-add natin. 4 minutes times, alam natin that 1 minute, ay, kinoconvert pala natin into hours, ano? Kinoconvert natin into hours. Baliktad yung ano ko. And 4 minutes. How many hours in 1 minute? Or how many minutes in 1 hour? 60, di ba? So 60 minutes in 1 hour. Tapos i-add din natin yung seconds. 58 seconds. 58 seconds times 1 hour is 3,600 seconds. So pag pinag-add natin yan, should be in hour. So yung time na yan should be in hour na. You know? So that's 13 plus 4 over 60 plus 58 over 3,600. Yan, yung decimal. Medyo ano. I-ano ko na lang. Sige. 13.0828 hour. And na, or you can, para gusto niyo ng mas ano, mas accurate, you can use fraction, okay? Eh di dito sa ano, kilometer per hour for letter A. For letter A, ano na, diretso na, yeah? Speed is equal to 1,633.8 kilometers divided by the time in hour. So that's 13.0828 28 hour. So yan na yung speed natin. So 1633.8 divided by yung sagot natin is 124.8817 kilometer per hour. Okay, and then convert natin ito into meters per second. You have many options ano to convert this one into meters per second. Ang pwede niyong gawin, doon sa given muna, i-convert ninyo itong kilometers to meters and then itong time into seconds para i-divide nyo lang, diretso na lang ulit. Ano? Pwede din, dito sa sagot nyo sa part A, i-convert nyo na diretso into meters per second. And yun yung gagawin natin. For letter B, speed is 124.8817 kilometers per hour times 1 kilometer is 1,000 meters times 1 hour is 3,600 seconds. So yan na yung speed natin in meters per second kasi cancel na yung kilometers tapos yung hour. Yan. So times 1,000 divided by 3,600. So we have 34.6894 meters per second. Okay, so yan na yung sagot natin for the speed in kilometers per hour and the speed in meters per second. Okay? All right. So I think meron tayong ano dito. Meron tayong class point question. Based from our discussion, what do you think does a car speedometer measures? Is it the speed, the velocity, or both speed and velocity? Speedometer, yun yung nasa sasakyan natin, ano? Meron din yung sa motor. Ano't ibagbaganan dyan, numano tartara yun. So what ano DJ ba, speed ba, velocity or both? You have 15 seconds to answer. Yan. So the correct answer is A. Actually, it's the speed, di ba? Siyempre yung speedometer, hindi naman niya pwedeng sabihin ano, kung saan ka patungo, walang direction. Basta sinasabi niya lang the magnitude. Gaano ka kabilis tumatakbo. Ano? So it's the speed. Yun yung difference ano, ng speed tsaka velocity. Kapag speed, that's the distance over time. So, kung sinasabi nating distance, walang direction, di ba? Sa velocity, that's displacement over time. So, kapag displacement, merong direction. Yung speedometer natin, it does not measure direction. It does not indicate the direction. So, speedometer is for speed. Yan. So, scalar quantity lang. Speed is a scalar quantity. Velocity is a vector quantity. May direction ang velocity. Ang speed, wala. Okay? Okay, ito. I think we have 3 minutes. A car travels at a constant 50 kilometers per hour for 100 kilometers. It then speeds up to 100 kilometers per hour and is driven another 100 kilometers. What is the car's average speed for the 200 kilometer trip? Is it A, 75, B, 66.6667, letter C, 76.6667, or letter D, 65 kilometers per hour? I'm going to give you 3 minutes to answer this one. Okay, the correct answer here is letter B. Kung titignan ninyo, ano, 50 kilometers per hour tsaka 100 kilometers. Some of you siguro ang ginawa bakit 700 kilometers per hour. Kasi average speed, baka ano na, ano lang. In average yung 50 kilometers per hour tsaka 100 kilometers per hour, which is equal to 75 kilometers per hour kapag ganon. Diba? Pero in this case, hindi. Hindi siya ganon, ano? So, ang average speed, when we talk about average speed, speed is equal to the total distance over total time. Ano? Or the elapsed time. Dito, kailangan nyo munang isolve yung time for each ano. So, dito sa una, 50 kilometers per hour for 100 kilometers. So, in this case, ilang oras siya, ano? 2 hours, di ba? Dito naman, 100 kilometers per hour for 100 kilometers. So, meron ditong 1 hour. 1 hour. So, sa pagpunta, 2 hours niya binayahe. Sa pagbalik, 1 hour. So, mas mabilis siya dito, ano? So, mas matagal siyang nag-travel at 50 kilometers per hour. So, hindi pwedeng i-ano lang ito. Hindi pwedeng i-average lang. Hindi pwedeng i-average lang yung kanilang speed. Okay? Kasi mas matagal siyang nagbiyahe at the speed of 50 kilometers per hour. So, ang sagot natin dapat dito, mas malapit kay 50 kilometers per hour kaysa kay 100 kilometers per hour. Kasi mas matagal siyang nag-travel ng 50 kilometers per hour. So, ang speed dapat dito is equal to the total distance, which is 200 kilometers over the total time, which is 2 plus 1 hour. Okay? So, ang sagot dyan is 66.6667 kilometers per hour. Okay? So, you just can't get the average of the two speeds dito. Alright? Tingnan natin yung responses ninyo. Tingnan natin yung leaderboard. Parehas pa rin, ano? 0058. Now, let's go to acceleration. Okay. So, napag-aralan na natin yung displacement, diba? Una, napag-aralan natin yung position. Position is the change. Position is where you are at a specific reference frame. Ngayon, kung nagbago yung position mo, meron kang displacement. Because displacement is the change in position. Tama? Ngayon, kapag nagbago yung displacement mo, kapag nagbago yung displacement mo, meron kang nagbago yung position mo with respect to time, meron kang velocity, di ba? Velocity is the change in displacement over change in time. Yan. So, iba yung velocity sa speed. Because speed is a scalar quantity, wala siyang direction. Whereas yung velocity, meron siyang direction. Kasi yung velocity nanggaling siya sa displacement. Displacement has a direction. So, yung velocity, meron din siyang direction. Ngayon, acceleration naman is, ano kaya yung acceleration? Kapag nabasa nyo, alam nyo yung acceleration. So, meron tayong tanong dito for class point. Which of the following has a negative velocity but a positive acceleration? So, di ba sabi natin velocity is a vector. So, pwede siyang kapag negative, ibig sabihin yung displacement natin negative. Di ba? Yung acceleration naman, when we talk about acceleration, this is the change in velocity. So, for example, kapag bumagal, kapag nagtatravel yung sasakyan mo, tapos bumagal yung kanyang takbo, we have a negative acceleration. Pero kung bumibilis yung takbo, we have a positive acceleration. So, ngayon ang tanong dito, pwede bang negative ang velocity pero positive ang acceleration? Pwede ba yon? Negative yung velocity. Ibig sabihin, the displacement is tapos positive yung acceleration. So which of the following has a negative velocity but a positive acceleration? Is it A, an object traveling to the left that is having a reduction in speed? B, an object traveling to the left that is having an increase in speed? An object traveling to the right that is having a reduction in speed? Or an object traveling to the right that is having an increase in speed? So with what do you think? Two minutes. Okay na. So I'm going to close the submission now. The correct answer is A. Ang daming nakakuha, 22. Ano ba yung A? An object traveling to the left that is having a reduction in speed. Pwede pa lang maging positive yung acceleration na nagre-reduce yung speed. Later on, mapapag-aralan natin yan kung bakit naging ganyan yan. Okay, so ano bang ibig sabihin natin ng average acceleration? So, an average acceleration is the rate at which the velocity changes. Diba? So, acceleration is the change in velocity over change in time. Kanina, velocity is the change in position over change in time. Diba? Displacement over time. Ngayon, acceleration na is the change in velocity over change in time. So, kagaya ng velocity, yung acceleration ay isa ding vector quantity. Kasi meron din siyang direction. Velocity, nakadepende sa displacement. Yung acceleration nakadepende sa velocity. So all of these are vector quantities. Okay? So acceleration is a vector in the same direction as the change in velocity. Since velocity is a vector, it can change either in magnitude or in direction. Acceleration is therefore a change in either speed or direction or both. Okay, so acceleration is a change in speed or change in direction or change in both speed and direction. Yun yung ano natin, definition natin ng acceleration. Ano? So, dito, pag-usapan natin yung change in speed. Madali lang yung change in speed. Change in speed is when you travel, for example, from 10 meters per second going to 20 meters per second. So that's acceleration. We have change in speed. Dito naman sa direction, if you go around in circles, for example, nakamotor ka, curve kuma, dito tayo motor mo, So ang you are traveling at say 20 kilometers per hour because this is steep tapos medyo mabagal yung mo. So constant naman yung speed mo at 20 kilometers per hour. Pero you are traveling in a curve. Ganyan, paliko. So are you accelerating or not? Although naka 20 kilometers per hour lang yung speed mo, but you are changing in direction. Diba? Nag-change ka ng direction at every instant dito sa curve na to. So ibig sabihin, meron ka pa ring acceleration. Okay? Meron ka pa ring acceleration. Later on, meron tayong quantity for acceleration in a curve direction later on at the later chapters of our study dito sa physics. Basta ang gusto ko lang na ipaalam sa inyo, pwede pa rin merong acceleration kahit na hindi nagbabago yung speed mo. Alright? Yan. So meron tayong term dito, dalawa. Deceleration versus negative acceleration. Yan. Ito na yung sagot sa tanong natin kanina, no? Deceleration always refers to acceleration in the direction opposite to the direction of the velocity. Deceleration always reduces speed. Okay, so deceleration is reducing the speed. Okay? Negative acceleration naman is an acceleration na nakadirect in the negative direction of our chosen coordinate system. Yun yung, kapag sinabi natin negative acceleration, negative yung acceleration na yun because of our coordinate system. Deceleration naman, it does not really matter kung anong direction siya, no? Direction, yung deceleration, it always reduces the speed. Yun yung term natin for deceleration. Okay. Let's take a look at these four figures dito. Assuming dito na to the right is positive. To the right is positive. Okay, dito sa figure A, the velocity, ibig sabihin itong car is moving to the right. Okay, the velocity is to the right. And the acceleration is also to the right. Okay, kapag sinabi natin dito, we have a positive acceleration kasi to the right yung acceleration natin. Alright? So it does not matter kung nare-reduce or nag-i-increase yung velocity. Basta alam natin that acceleration is to the right. So we have a positive acceleration. Ngayon, ang tanong natin susunod, itong acceleration ba na ito, it reduces the speed or it increases the speed? Ang sagot natin dito, depende kung parehas ba yung direction ng velocity natin sa acceleration. Kung titingnan ninyo, parehas. The acceleration, parehas ng direction sa velocity. Ano ang effect nito? Ang effect nito, yung acceleration, dinadagdag sa velocity. Ibig sabihin, nag-i-increase yung velocity natin. Okay? Yun yung ibig sabihin ng dalawang arrow na ito, the velocity and the acceleration. Okay? The velocity is to the right, the acceleration is also to the right. Therefore, we have a positive acceleration and we also have hindi siya deceleration kasi nag-i-increase yung speed. Okay? Dito sa letter B, anong pinagkaiba? Itong acceleration na natin is opposite of the velocity. Opposite na sila. Ibig sabihin, itong acceleration na ito is already opposing yung velocity. At the same time, itong acceleration na ito is to the left. Tama? Ibig sabihin, kapag to the left ka, edi negative acceleration. So this is a negative acceleration. Yan. So, negative acceleration na nga, deceleration pa. Okay, parehas. Negative acceleration because of the direction. Deceleration because it is opposite the direction of the velocity. It reduces the speed. Pinapa, Pinapatagal. Anong pinapatagal? It reduces the speed. For letter C, as you can see, opposite na naman yung velocity tsaka acceleration. Ang clue natin dito, kapag opposite yung acceleration tsaka velocity, we have a reduce. Nagre-reduce yung speed. Okay? Basta opposite yung velocity tsaka acceleration, nare-reduce yung speed. In this case, itong sasakyan natin is going to the left. Ibig sabihin yung velocity natin is negative. Velocity is negative because the displacement is negative going to the left eh. Diba? So as you can see, itong acceleration natin going to the right. So we have a positive acceleration. And in this case, it reduces the velocity. It reduces the velocity, itong acceleration natin. So we have a positive acceleration, but we have a deceleration. We have a positive acceleration because to the right yung acceleration natin. But since this is opposite the velocity, it reduces the speed. Therefore, we have a deceleration. For letter D, kung titignan niyo parehas, ano? Parehas yung direction ng acceleration tsaka velocity. So yung velocity at tsaka acceleration, ini-increase niya yung speed niya. Itong acceleration nito, ini-increase yung speed ng velocity. Okay? Itong velocity, negative. We also have a negative acceleration kasi to the left din yung acceleration. But this one is not a deceleration. Hindi siya deceleration kasi hindi niya pinapabagal yung sasakyan. Instead, dinadagdagan niya ng speed because parehas yung kanilang direction eh. Okay? So that is the difference between a negative acceleration and a deceleration. So when we talk about negative acceleration, we only talk about the direction, the acceleration. But when we talk about deceleration, we talk about whether the speed is reducing or it's increasing. Diba? Yun yung ano, pinagkaiba ng negative acceleration sa deceleration. Okay? So I hope this is clear. Meron tayong apat na scenario dito. Yung tanong kanina, anong scenario ba yung tanong kanina? Ano yung tanong? Ito, negative velocity, positive acceleration. Negative velocity, meaning to the left, positive acceleration. Itong letter C, di ba? Negative velocity, positive acceleration. Nagre-reduce yung speed natin dito. Kasi opposite yung direction ng velocity tsaka acceleration. Okay? Kung kanina meron tayong instantaneous velocity, meron din tayong instantaneous acceleration. Diba? Yung instantaneous, at an instant, ano? Yung kaya based from the word instant. Kaya instantaneous acceleration is the acceleration as at a specific instant in time. Okay? Yan. So, a racehorse coming out of the gate accelerates from rest to a velocity of 15.0 meters per second due west in 1.8 seconds. What is its average acceleration? Okay, tingnan natin kung ano yung mga given natin dito. Ano? Sabi from rest. Ang ibig sabihin nito, we started from a velocity of zero. Kasi from rest. So our initial velocity, V sub zero, is zero. To a velocity of 15.0 meters per second. So our final velocity is 15.0 meters per second. Due west, ibig sabihin to the left. So ibig sabihin, negative. Negative 15.0 meters per second. Okay? And then our time is 1.8 seconds. Yan. So we are given the initial and final velocities we also are given the time. So we are now, we can now solve for acceleration. Okay, the average acceleration is the change in velocity over change in time, or that is BF minus VO all over time T. Diba? Yan yung formula natin for acceleration. Acceleration, therefore, is negative 15.0 meters per second minus 0 all over 1.8 seconds. So, acceleration is, ano natin dito? Okay, we have negative 15 divided by 1.8. Okay, we have negative 8.3333. This is meter per second per second. So, ang ibig sabihin nito, nagbabago ng negative 8.3333 meters per second kada segundo yung acceleration natin. Okay, yung object natin. Okay, in ano, we can also write this as negative 8.3333 meters per second square. Okay? Yan yung unit natin, meter per second square, or a unit length divided by the square of the time. Yun yung unit natin for acceleration. Okay? So kapag negative yung acceleration, ano ang ibig sabihin nito kapag negative yung acceleration? Dalawa lang naman ang pwede, ha? Pwedeng isa sa dalawa, no? Una, pwede na yung displacement natin ay to the left. Di ba? Kasi kung negative yung displacement mo, usually negative na rin yung velocity mo. At saka yung change in velocity negative na din. To the left yung motion. Or pwede din na decelerating. Okay? Decelerating siya. Na mas mabilis una and then mas mabagal na at the later time. Okay? In this case, ano ba ang case dito? Negative 15. To the west at saka direction ito, ano? Due west kasi. Yung final position kasi natin, final velocity natin is due west. Okay? So yung acceleration, ulitin ko, can be a change in speed, a change in direction, or both. Okay? Dr. John Paul Staff was U.S. Air Force officer who studied the effects of extreme deceleration on the human body. On December 10, 1954, Staff rode a rocket sled accelerating from rest to a top speed of 282 meters per second in just 5 seconds. And he was brought jarringly back to rest in only 1.4 seconds. Wow. Calculate his acceleration and deceleration. Okay, acceleration muna doon from, di ba nag-ano siya, from rest, pumunta siya sa 282 meters per second. So that's our acceleration for letter A, you know. So the acceleration is equal to the change in velocity over change in time. So the final velocity is 282 meters per second minus the initial velocity is 0 divided by the time. We have 5 seconds, 5.00 seconds. So we have an average acceleration of 282 divided by 5 seconds. We have 56.4, ano? 56.4 meters per second square. For his deceleration, the acceleration is, dito naman, from the top speed of 282 meters per second, nag-stop siya, no? Back to rest, in just 1.4 seconds. So our final velocity is zero minus the initial velocity of 282 meters per second divided by the time, which is 1.4 seconds. So here we have a negative acceleration. In this case, this is a deceleration. So this is negative 282 over 1.4. Imagine at negative 201.4286 meters per second square. Oh my gulay, di ba? So express each in multiples of g by taking its ratio to the acceleration due to gravity. So we can actually express this in terms of g, ano? Maglagay ako ng ano dito. In terms of g, maglagay lang ako ng, i-divide lang natin ito ng 9.8. Okay? So this one is equal to 56.4 divided by 9.8. Mali ba yung computation ko? Hindi pa naman nag-end yung class point. Okay, so we have dito we have 5.7551 g. Yeah, dito we have negative of 201.4286 divided by 9.8. So dito meron tayong negative 20.5539 g. Yeah. G is 9.8, given dito. G is equal to 9.8 meters per second. So basically, ang ginawa lang natin dito, kinumpute natin ito with in multiples of G. Para makuha natin yon, i-divide lang natin ito. 56.4 divided by 9.8. So whatever the answer, lagyan lang natin ng G. 5.7551 G. Dito, 201.4286 divided by 9.8. Kaya naging negative 20.5539. Tapos linagyan natin ng G. Okay? Okay na? Another example, a commuter backs her car out of her garage with an acceleration of 1.40 meters per second square. How long does it take her to reach a speed of 2 meters per second? If she then brakes to stop in 0.8 second, what is her deceleration? So, ito, commuter backs her car out of her garage, meaning she started at a velocity of zero, tama? And then, how long does it take for her to reach a speed of 2? So for A, the acceleration is equal to the change in velocity over change in time. Okay? Yeah. So but since ito, we do not take into account na yung kanilang direction, ano? So pwede nang speed ang gamitin for average acceleration. The average acceleration is the speed, initial speed or final speed, that's 2.0 meters per second minus the initial speed, which is 0. Ano? 0 meters per second divided by the time. Given pala yung acceleration natin. So we can actually equate this to the acceleration over the time. Yung time yung unknown kasi how long. So the time is equal to 1.4 meters per second square. So for letter A, the time is just equal to 1.4 divided by 2. Tama? Or 2 divided by 1.4, I'm sorry. 2 divided by 1.4. So the time is 1.4286 seconds. Okay. So 2 divided by 1.4. For letter B, if she then breaks to stop in 0.8 seconds, so that's the time, what is her deceleration? We are looking for A, you know? So from 2 meters per second to 0, so that's 0 minus 2 meters per second divided by the time of 0.800 seconds. So the acceleration, this is deceleration since this is negative, so negative 2 over 0.8. We have negative 2.5 meters per second square. Okay, so that's the deceleration. Do you have any question? Yeah, okay. I think we are done with... ito, sagutan natin. Class point for 3 minutes. A car moving in a straight line starts at x equals 0 at t equals 0. It passes the point x is equal to 25 meters with a speed of 11.0 meters per second at time t equals 3 seconds. It passes the point x is equal to 385 meters with a speed of 45.0 meters per second at t equals 20 seconds. Find the average velocity and the average acceleration between 3 seconds and t equals 20 seconds. So at point, t equals 3 seconds and t equals 20 seconds. First, we need to find for the average velocity. And then next, we need to find for the average acceleration. Okay, you have 3 minutes to answer this one in your class point and your time starts now. Okay, last 5 seconds. Wala na. Okay na, 10, 9, 8. Okay, so I'm going to close the submission now. The correct answer is B. Okay, given naman na yung velocities natin, di ba? Given na yung position, no? Position at 3 equals at t equals 3 seconds, that's 25. Tapos at 20 seconds, that's 385. So for the velocity, subtract lang natin yan. 385 minus 25 divided by 20 minus 3. Di ba? The velocity is just the change in position, 385 minus 25, all over the change in time. So that's 20 minus 3 seconds. The acceleration naman is the change in velocity over time. Given naman na yung velocity, 45 minus 11, this is in meters per second, divided by the change in time. So that's 20 minus 3. So it should be direct lang ano, and you should, the answer should be letter B. Okay. All right. Now for this part, we're now going to talk about the relationships between acceleration, velocity, displacement, using equations. Okay, so these equations are what we call kinematic equations or kinematical equations. Okay, so motion equations for constant acceleration in one dimension. Remember, itong pag-usapan natin na susunod, constant yung acceleration. Ibig sabihin, hindi nagbabago-bago ano yung acceleration. But I think before our discussion, merong tanong dito. This is another ano. For a motion with constant acceleration, the average velocity will be midway between the initial and final velocities. So parang ang sinasabi nito, yung average velocity ba ay nasa gitna mismo ng initial and final velocities kapag constant yung acceleration. So for example, if I want to get the average velocity, i-add ko lang yung initial tsaka final velocities divided by 2. I can come up with the average velocity. So is that true or false? 15 seconds. Okay. Sige, marami pang sumasagot. Hanggang 30 seconds na lang. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, so the answer is letter A. Yes. We can actually do that. It's true, ano? So the average velocity, since constant naman yung acceleration, ibig sabihin parang meron tayong linear, di ba? Linear yan. Kasi constant, parang yung slope niya yung acceleration. Okay? So, we just get the average of the initial and final velocities to solve for the average velocity. Yan. So, these are the kinematic equations. Ano? These are the kinematic equations that we are going to use for this part of our discussion. So, etong mga equations na to, galing sila sa mga formulas. Pwede nyo nang ilista ito. Galing din sila sa mga discussion natin. For example, dito sa unang equation, this came from the equation na the average velocity is equal to the change in position over change in time. So that's xf minus xo all over time. Yan. So if you are solving for xf, so xf is equal to xo plus the average velocity times t. So, tingnan mo parehas lang. But in our case, dito sa discussion natin, hindi na natin lalagyan ng sub f yung final. Ano? So, kaya naging x is equal to xo plus vt. Ito na lang yung formula natin. Wala nang sub f dito. Okay? For our notation, wala na yung sub f. The same is true for final velocities and yun, xf tsaka final velocity, dalawa. Okay, ito na yung sinasabi ko kanina, ano? Yung velocity, the average velocity, we just add, ano? We just add yung initial at saka yung final velocity, dito final, pero hindi na natin isusulat yung f, ano? The initial and final velocity and then divide by 2. This is for constant acceleration, ano? We cannot do this kapag hindi constant yung acceleration. Yan. Ito, itong pangatlong equation natin, this came from the formula for acceleration, di ba? Acceleration is final velocity minus initial velocity over time. So if we compute for the final velocity, so the final velocity is equal to the initial velocity plus at. Pero hindi natin isusulat yung f, kaya ito na yung naging formula natin. That v is equal to vo plus at. Yan. So galing itong formula na ito, galing din sa formula ng acceleration natin. Okay? Itong formula na to, delta x is equal to vot plus 1/2 at squared. This one came from yung ano natin. Galing din siya sa formula natin na ito, no? Okay. So parang ano, parang pinagsama-sama itong tatlong basic formulas na ito to come up with this formula and also with this formula. Okay? So yung derivation naman ito nasa book ninyo. Galing naman siya sa galing lang siya basically sa tatlong fundamental equations na to. Formula for velocity, yung average velocity and the formula for acceleration. Pag pinagsama-sama yung tatlong 'yan, we'll come up with these two equations. Yan. So dito sa una, this is delta x. Ano? Ibig sabihin, this is x minus xo. The final velocity minus the initial velocity is equal to vot plus 1/2 at squared. Dito, final velocity is equal to the squared. Mayroong squared. Is equal to the initial velocity squared plus 2a delta x. This is still xf minus xo or x minus xo. Yan. So yan, itong limang ito, ito yung ginagamit natin ng mga equations kapag constant yung acceleration natin. Okay? Kapag constant yung acceleration. Actually, this one, itong unang equation na to, hindi naman involve ang acceleration. Ano? This one, ginagamit natin for siguro constant velocity. Ito na lang. This one ginagamit natin for constant velocity siguro, ano? Also with hindi ito dapat constant yung acceleration. Itong una lang pwede nating gamitin 'yan kahit hindi naka-specify na for constant velocity. Kapag kasi constant yung velocity, zero yung acceleration. Tama naman, constant pa rin naman yung acceleration kahit constant yung velocity. Constant at zero, tama? Kasi kapag steady yung velocity niya, yung acceleration natin zero. Walang change in velocity. Ito yun. Applicable itong formula na to for acceleration equals zero. Okay? Okay, yan. Yung tatlong o limang formulas natin. Pwede nyo nalang isulat yan sa mga ano ninyo, sa mga kung meron kayong pinagsusulatan ng mga formulas, isulat nyo yan, yung limang yan. And then, this is the recommended. Hindi, wala namang, ano, wala namang perfect na problem-solving technique. Ano? Pero this is the recommended na ano natin, na technique natin for solving one-dimensional kinematics. Okay, number one, examine the situation to determine which physical principles are involved. It often helps to draw a simple sketch at the outset. You will also need to decide which direction is positive and note that on your sketch. So ibig sabihin, ay bakit may ones dyan? Ibig sabihin nito, we understand. Dapat i-understand natin yung situation in the problem. Alright? And then susunod, we need to identify which among the quantities are knowns and which are unknown. Pangatlo, ay pang-apat na kasi 2 and 3, identify the knowns and the unknowns. Pang-apat, kapag na-identify na natin yung known tsaka unknown, pwede na tayong pumilis dito sa 5 formulas natin dito kung ano ang gagamitin natin based from the given. And then, isolve natin yung unknown. And then, kapag na-solve na natin yung unknown, i-check natin, does it make sense? Is our answer reasonable? Ganon, ano? Let's take a look at this one. Let's take a look at this one. So a jogger runs down a straight stretch of road with an average velocity of 4 meters per second for 2 minutes. What is his final position, taking his initial position to be 0? Okay, so I think this is ano, madali lang intindi nito. Ano? This is easy to understand. We have a jogger running. So we have his final initial position going to his final position. Okay? So let us draw a sketch. Simple sketch. Okay? So we have here the initial position. And we have the final. Okay? So the jogger runs from the initial to final. Yan. So let us identify the knowns and the unknowns. Dito, meron tayong 4 meters per second. That is the average velocity. So our, okay, isulat natin dito, knowns. Or pwede given. You know? Knowns or given. So the average velocity, so that's V bar. The average velocity is 4 meters per second. Etong 2 minutes na to, this is the time. Diba? This is the elapsed time. Time T is equal to 2 minutes. Pwede nating i-convert into seconds ito para maging homogeneous yung ating units, okay? We know that 1 minute is 60 seconds. So, yung 2 minutes natin, pwede din nating isulat as 120 seconds. And then, what is his final position taking his initial position to be 0? So yung x sub 0 natin ay equal siya sa 0. Yan yung knowns natin. Okay, yung unknown natin or yung required. Okay, yung required na variable natin is the final position, di ba? What is his final position? So in this case, ang required natin ay x. Okay, let us examine. Meron tayong average velocity, time. Ang involved dito, ano? Average velocity, time, XO, tsaka X. Diba? Yan yung apat na involved na variables. Ang hindi involved dito ay yung acceleration. Diba? Wala tayong nakikitang acceleration. Punta lang tayo doon sa list of formulas natin and identify natin yung formula para mas madali tingnan natin yung formula na hindi involved yung acceleration. Itong dalawang ito, involve yung acceleration. Meron tayong acceleration dito. Dito meron. So, dito meron ding acceleration. Ito, hindi in, ito average velocity lang. So, basically, ito na yung formula natin. X is equal to XO plus VT. Yan na yung formula natin. Okay? So, our formula, X is equal to XO plus the average velocity times time. And then next step is to substitute yung mga knowns natin. So X is equal to XO, that's 0, plus the average velocity is 4.00 meters per second. And then the time is 120 seconds. Okay? So the final position is 4 times 180. We can cancel second, di ba? So ang ano natin, unit natin is meters. That's 480. Meters. So yan na yung sagot natin. No? Does it make sense? Running for 4 meters per second for 2 minutes, of course, it makes sense. Okay? So pwede kang makapag-travel ng 480 meters physically running for 2 minutes at 4 meters per second. Okay? So ito na yung sagot natin. All right. Another example. An airplane lands with an initial velocity of 70.0 meters per second and then decelerates at 1.5 meter per second square for 40 seconds. What is its final velocity? Okay? So, understanding the situation, itong airplane nag-start siya from 70 meters per second. And then nag-decelerate siya. Ibig sabihin, we have bumabagal. So from 70.0, bumabagal siya. Until for 40 seconds, tinatanong niya, ano na ngayon yung final velocity after 40 seconds? So ito na yung mga knowns natin or the given values. Okay? So the given, we have an initial velocity that's V sub 0. So that's VO is 70.0 meters per second. And then decelerates, ibig sabihin this is negative. Yung acceleration natin is negative 1.5 meters per second square. And then the time is 40.0 seconds. And ang required sa atin is the final velocity or V. Yan. So, ang involved, V, VO, A, tsaka T. Kung titignan natin sa formulas natin, V, VO, yan, V, VO, A, tsaka T. Diretso, ito na. V is equal to VO plus AT. Diba? So, yun na yung ating formula, no? So our formula is V is equal to VO plus AT. And then the, substituting the given values, we have VO is 70.0 meters per second plus the acceleration, which is negative 1.5 meters per second square, and then multiplied by 40.0 seconds. So dito, we have a unit of meters per second. So 70 meters minus 40 times 1.5 is 60. Okay? So we have 70 minus 1.5 times 40, we have 10. Yan. So syempre, bumabagal na yung ating. So from 70, naging 10 meters na lang after 40 seconds. Okay. So this is now our final, that is now our final velocity. Okay? Okay, let's take a look at this one. Dragsters can achieve an average acceleration of 26.0 meters per second square. Suppose such a dragster accelerates from rest at this rate for 5.56 seconds. How far does it travel in this time? Okay, let's take a look at the given. Okay, average acceleration. So we have an acceleration of 26.0 meters per second square. And then, it starts from rest, di ba? From rest, so the initial velocity is 0 at this rate for 5.56 seconds. So the time is 5.56 seconds. How far does it travel in this time. So our required is how far, meaning this is the displacement or the change in position, delta x. So the required is delta x, assuming that this one is moving in a straight line. Para yung delta x equal lang siya doon sa distance traveled. Okay? So ang unknown dito is delta x. So let's take a look at the formulas involving acceleration, velocity, initial velocity actually, the time, and delta x. Let's take a look at our formulas. I think itong formula na to, kasi we have delta x, given tayo ng VO, ng time, and then acceleration. So this one is applicable, ano? So our formula is delta x is equal to VOT plus 1/2 AT squared. Okay? So delta x, substituting yung mga given natin, since VO is 0, so this whole thing is equal to 0. Kasi 0 naman yung V sub 0. Okay, plus 1/2, A is 26.0 meters per second square, times the time, which is 5.56 seconds square. Cancel na yung square dito kasi na second square. So our resulting unit is meters. Okay, so delta x is equal to 1/2 times 26 times 5.56 squared. So we have 401.8768 meters. So yan yung difference in position. Ibig sabihin yan na yung na-travel niya. That's the change in position. That's the displacement. Okay? So ito na yung sagot natin for the problem. All right? Huwag na yan. Suppose a car merges into a freeway traffic and 200 meter long ramp. If its initial velocity is 10 meters and it accelerates at 2 meters per second square, how long does it take to travel the 200 meter up the ramp? I think this is madali na lang din ito, ano, because the same, meron ng formula. Nagamit na natin yung formula niya kanina. Just identify the given and substitute the given in the formula. Basta gawin nyo lang yun. You identify the given and the unknown, tapos tingnan ninyo doon sa formula kung ano yung applicable to solve for the unknown. Yeah. A rocket accelerates at a rate of 20 meters per second squared during launch. How long does it take the rocket to reach a velocity of 400 meters per second square? Okay, what are our given dito? Oh, given tayo ng acceleration. The acceleration is 20 meters per second square. How long does it take the rocket to reach a velocity? So, of course, a rocket is started from zero. So, the initial velocity is zero. And the final velocity is 400 meters per second. Okay? So, ang required sa atin dito, the required quantity is the time. How long? Okay? Time. So, VO tsaka VF ang given. So, doon sa formula natin, yung huli, meron tayong formula na V squared is equal to VO squared plus 2A delta X. Pero ang ano natin dito, dalawa yung hindi natin alam. Ay, isa lang, delta X dito. Pero ang tinatanong kasi is time. Ang tinatanong dito is time. E dito, pwede nating ma-compute yung delta x. Okay, ang tanong, meron pa bang mas applicable na formula to solve for the time directly? Okay. So, balik tayo doon sa mga formulas natin. Ang mga dito, involved yung time, involved yung final velocity. Actually, itong formula lang na ito yung involved yung initial velocity and final velocity. Di ba? Alright. Ay, ito. Final velocity is initial velocity plus 80. Ito pala, no? Meron din tayong final velocity, initial velocity plus 80 dito. So, ito pala, diretso na. Pwede yung final velocity is initial velocity plus 80. Yan, diretso na pwedeng makompute yung time dito. Okay? So, substituting itong given natin, the final velocity, actually this is, di ba sabi ko kanina, hindi na natin ilalagay yung final. So, this is 400 meters per second is equal to 0 plus acceleration is 20 meters per second square times the time. Okay? So, the time is equal to 400 meters per second divided by 20 meters per second square. So, yan na yung time. 400 divided by 20 is 20. 20 seconds. And all right. So, ay, meron tayong ano dito, class point ulit. Just to check your understanding, a car starts from rest and accelerates at a constant 10 meters per second square during a 402 meter race. How fast is the car going at the finish line? Okay? So it starts from rest, accelerates, ito yung acceleration, during a, ito yung total distance na traveled. How fast is the car going at the finish line? So you have siguro 2 minutes to answer this one. Okay, time is up. Close the submission now. Yeah, so the correct answer is letter B. 90 meters per second. Okay. It's fine. Okay. So let's have a break siguro. 10 minutes break. And then be back here at 10 minutes for our next topic. Our next topic is on falling objects. Do not close your class point.
Sir, at the damag ko po.
Yes.
Hanggang anong oras tayo, sir?
Hanggang 6 siguro. Apay.
Awan, sir.
Boring kan?
Cancer at the papanan meet 5 gawin ka damama sir.
Ay, mabali mat na ag out ka.
Sige sir.
Ay, palaban si ano ah. 0058. 100% correct. Yung number 6 natin is at 62% correct na yan. Ibig sabihin, mas mababa na sa 62 yung mga... Na disconnect sa class point man di ba mairaman ang gijay answers nga correct idin imo na sir no nagalaglag out the class point may record met la jay imo na score no pa sir I don't know ang kupay na padasan we'll see kita to no kasano i-email dakto man da kita nang kalag out i-email dakto ta kita no na i-record na. Apa yung ilag out yung class point yo? Tapos hindi ko nag-reload, nag-login kay ulit, in-click, in-anayo ulit ti class code. Adda kanuhan nga ni-record ti class point na kasi na log out. Hindi nag-change device kayo. Madine i-record agad yung daduma. Pero the same yung, ano, yung DJ Inquayo nga name na. Isang kontolata di jay ano yon? Scores yun tap na makita yon. Ano nga tani i-record? Amamat siguro. The same student number ting kwayo. Aman siguro. Kitan tayo ito. Lagi tayo na, nag-log out ti class point na i-email dakta kitakto. Ano nga number kayo nga ano nga question kayo nga nag-log out. Wano kahit yung ituloy tayo man ng next Saturday na malum sa unag, Paison? Nakaasin na kita, Daduma?
Win, sir.
Sir.
Win, sir.
Win, sir. Win, sir.
Win, sir. Win, sir.
Win, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir.
Sir. Wait lang. Sino yung ano? Sino yung mga na-log out sa class point? Tignan ko nga yung scores dito. Sino na yung ano, magbenga kayo ng student number. Okay, let's try. Dapat agad tayo nag-answer, na-log out, tapos nag-answer ulit. Tayo nag-answer, tapos na-log out, tapos nag-answer ulit. Try ko man dito yan ha. Sige, Elaine. Elaine Joy. Let me see. Elaine Joy. Meron naman, Elaine. Meron ka lang dalawang hindi nasagutan. Hindi ka sumagot sa dalawang questions. Recorded naman. Sige. Let me check another one. Si Sir, ano? Altea. Zero five zero zero six six. 12 out of 13 yung participation mo. So recorded. Recorded siya. Recorded. Kahit na disconnect kayo, recorded siya. When recorded lahat, kahit na disconnect kayo, recorded yung mga ano nyo. Recorded naman. So walang problema. I-stop recording ko na, no?